I'm in a little ravine right now. And oftentimes in these kinds of ravines, these embankments, like here, are perfect for trapdoor spiders to make their burrows, specifically Aliatypus species. This one being a californicus. So I'm gonna see if I can find any. So already here, you can see a door on this embankment next to this sage. Not a very large species by any means, but this isn't an adult, to be fair. But I'm gonna see if I can find the spider, start excavating. And before I completely break this thing apart, I'll show you the door open. There it is right there. See, the hole goes back there. Alright, I can see the spider in there. See if you can too. Can you? No, completely dark. But watch. I just clear a little bit of this with my hand. Then there, you can see the spider. Not a great shot, but you can see its legs in there. So now I'm gonna dig a little bit below it. And there it is. Not a very large specimen. Come on, come on. I'm gonna see if I can find an adult instead. So actually, quite close to the area I was digging, there's another little one right here. I'm not going to dig it up. I'm just gonna show you the door. There it is. I'm not going to go after that one because, like I said, I want to go after an adult, but also I found another sub-adult burrow right here in the same general area as where I found the other one. Let's see if I can open this door for you too. There you go. So I'm going to see if I can dig that one up, and then I'm going to find an adult for real. Well, let the digging commence. This entire piece is gonna fall off here, but I don't want to lose the burrow, so I'm going to... Actually, there's no saving this. Let's see what I see behind. There we go. That's the burrow right there. Leading into here and out on this side. Oops. Oh well. There, you can see through. Anyway. Always gotta clear these roots. I think this one belongs to the sage. I obstructed the burrow a bit. That's fine though. Clear a little bit in front of it. There it is. Hold on. Let me take it out. Got it. There. Oh, yeah. This is the area I was digging, and then I followed up. And there's an adult burrow right here. This will undoubtedly be a larger specimen than the last two. Possibly an adult. I hope it's an adult. There's also another one right here that's much smaller. Here's another one that I'm not gonna dig up, but Some of them are in some bizarre places. That's a door right there. Can't really open it, but it is a door. All right, I'm now going to start digging up this suspect adult specimen. Look at that. Door is still in place, but the burrow surrounding it is gone. Smells extremely fragrant because I think these may be roots from sage, this stuff. It's actually what I'm holding on to keep from falling down the slope. A few centimeters to go, so I can do this more practically. Now I should be able to poke it out with my tongs. There it is. And that is an adult. Let me retrieve it. Where do you think you're going? Come back. Where do you think you're going? Come on, focus, please. There. They don't get much larger than this at all. This is the fourth and final spider I'm going to dig up, and then I'm going to stop. There it is. Get over here. Last one. This one's also a subadult. Only one adult today, three subadults. Still pretty good. I am back in the same ravine where I found the Aliatypus californicus trapdoor spiders. And I'm on these banks right now, and you can see old burrows that have been long abandoned here, and then this one over here too, here. But over down here is a very much active burrow of Promyrmekiaphila clathrata. Again, here is the lid. And this one may be an adult, probably a subadult though. The burrows certainly get larger than this. I did some prerequisite digging here so that I have a face to work with. And now the rest should be pretty straightforward. I can see the spider down there already. Gotta dig more. The ground is getting quite tough. And here it is. No, come on, get out.
There it is.
Looks to be not an adult, but a subadult. Yeah.
It just went up its little escape hatch.
Not too much of an issue. They usually don't go very far. So what I'm gonna do now is plug this up with dirt so it doesn't go back in there. And now, actually get in that little hole. Here. There it is again. Yeah, this one maybe has one more molt left to go, but still quite a large specimen. Reaching maturity pretty fast. It looks as though there's another Promyrmekiaphila clathrata wafer lid door up here. Hold on, let me get these dead branches out of the way. Up in here. Open it up too. Very asymmetrical lid. Just not very typical of these. I guess it's shaped like an egg. I don't know what's going on. Oh, looks like I cut straight to it. I'm gonna take away this bridge though. Onward. And there's the escape in there too. Wow, this one is quite long. Wow. And I'm only saying that because usually this escape is much closer to the bottom of the burrow. This one seems to be, it's already halfway between, which is quite strange. I'm actually gonna check the escape really quickly because if it's in there, I'm wasting my time. I don't think so. Oh wait, no, it is. It is in there. Okay, good. I'm just going to put this in here just so that it doesn't run in there. And now I'll just get this with this, and it should come right out. There it is. Ah, come back. This is quite a nice one. A bit larger than the last.